Given a rectangle with length a squared plus 6a minus 27 and width a squared minus 9, write the ratio of the width of the rectangle to its length as a simplified rational expression. And rational expression is kind of a fancy word, essentially for a fraction or as a ratio. So they want us to express the ratio of the length, so we'll put the length in the numerator, the length to the width. The length to the width. And in the problem, they tell us that the length right here is a squared plus 6a minus 27. A squared plus 6a minus 27. And then the width, they tell us right here, is a squared minus 9. So the width is a squared minus 9. So we've already expressed it as a rational expression, but this isn't necessarily a simplified rational expression. And whenever you have any rational expression, let's say we have, let me just go back to what you learned a long time ago. If I had something like 2 over 6, that's a rational expression, or that's also a fraction. But this isn't in the most simplified form. What you could do is you factor both of these. You could say, well, 2 is 1. Well, it's just, well, if you do a prime factorization, it's just 2. But 6 is 2 times 3. So when you factor them, you see that you have the same factor in the numerator and the denominator. You can cancel them out, and you can simplify it to 1/3. Now, we're going to do the exact same thing with these algebraic expressions. We can factor them, and then see if they have any of the same terms. If they have the same terms on the numerator and the denominator, then we can cancel them out. And then we'll just be left with, we'll be left with whatever's left over. So let's see if we can factor this numerator right here. So this is going to be equal to, let me draw the line there. So a squared plus 6a minus 27. Can we think of two numbers that if we multiply and we get negative 27, and so they're going to have to be of different signs, because when you multiply them, you get a negative number. And when you add them, you get positive 6. Let's see, 9 and 9 minus 3 is 6. 9 times negative 3 is negative 27. So this top expression is a plus 9 times a minus 3. We factored it there. And then what does this bottom expression factor into? Well, this is that standard form, if you remember, a squared minus b squared, where in this case, b would be 3. B squared would be 9. And we know that this is equal to a plus b times a minus b. So in this situation, we know this is a special form that would be factored into a plus 3 times a minus 3. Now, we see there is a term that is common to both the numerator and the denominator. A minus 3, you have an a minus 3 in the numerator, and you have an a minus 3 in the denominator. So we can divide the numerator and the denominator by a minus 3, or that they would cancel out. Or a minus 3 divided by a minus 3, assuming that a is not equal to 3, because then it would become undefined. But if we assume a does not equal to 3, something divided by itself will just be 1 right there. And then we'll just be left with a plus 9 over a plus 3. And that's about as simplified as we can get for this rational expression.